Hi, welcome to Motorcycle News. My name is John Urry and we're here at the Coniston Hotel 4x4 Centre up in Skipton to ride a very, very special motorcycle. This is the bike that trials legend Dougie Lampkin wheelied the entire way around the TT course. It's a standard Vertigo Ice Hell. That's a 300cc two-stroke single. It makes about 23 horsepower and it weighs about 70 kilograms. It's had a lot of modifications to make it achieve the feat that Dougie managed on it. Front here, you've got a brake, but that isn't a front brake, that is actually a rear brake. This bike has two rear brake systems, one on your foot, which is operated by a mountain bike caliper, and that one operates a second mountain bike caliper as well. You obviously notice these pegs here. These are mountain bike pegs. Again, Dougie stood on the back axle for the entire 37 miles in an hour and a half attempt. It was just a weight distribution easier to keep the wheelie up, because remember, he couldn't drop it at any point. And that's also notice this fuel tank here, he only used 7 litres, but because he only went 37 miles. But he had to extend it and also make sure that it's permanently fuel, because the bike was always up at the whole time. So any airlock, any lack of fuel, the front goes down. Now I have the biggest modification here. Side here is a little electric motor. Now that is actually a mountain bike motor and it runs off a battery. It's located inside here. When you're wheeling, obviously for 37 miles, the front wheel's going to stop moving. If the front wheel stops moving, you haven't got the balance quite. So they've put an electric motor on so Dougie can keep the wheel moving to give himself better balance while he's wheeling. It's actually operated by a little lever here. So while he's going along, Dougie would alter the speed of that to help keep the wheelie going. Other than that, it's, well, pretty much a standard bike. There's been a few modifications to the engine for oil flow. Obviously, with a bike upright, you need to alter to make sure the engine's always got oil coming through to it into the gearbox. It's a bigger two-stroke. The oil is in with the fuel for the piston. Obviously, this is a very special bike because this is the machine that completed that amazing feat at the Isle of Man course. But I'm about to ride his practice bike, which is absolutely identical. Now, so I'm nervous is a bit of an understatement. I can wheelie a motorbike, or I can wheelie a road motorcycle. Well, I like to think with a degree of competency, but this is an entirely different thing. One, I can't do stand-up wheelies, so that's an interesting one. Two, I've not really ridden a trials bike before, so that's going to be quite unique. And a third thing, I've got a multiple world champion, 12 times world trials champion, watching me. To some nervous is something of an understatement, but I'm sure Doug will be nice and sympathetic. Northerners are known for their sympathetic when people are nervous. I'm sure everything will be fine. Do you ever get one of those hold my pint and watch these moments? This ain't gonna go well. Oh god, what have I let myself in for?
I'm watching our riding!
I'm hoping to watch.
Anything before, as this is first time. What gear are we in now?
It feels like the first time. Right.
Just set off to start off with in fourth and then just have a, get a feel for
it. I'm okay to sit on this, it's a great place to sit on it.
No, don't sit on
that. I've got a fat arse, so
you stand up on this. Right, you don't sit down, it's a trials bike.
Okay. Ready.
think he's going to get it.
I'm literally out of breath, I don't know why, just bouncing it, I think.
You've only ridden for it,
that's a long way!
Oh, yeah, it must be. What, 400 or 500 metres, are
we? Why do
we? No, it's not that far, it's 300.
I might put away in 4 foot, it. Southern Trolls run would be sympathetic.
You don't have any. Got it, lad, you've done about 20 metres.
Give me 37 metres.
37 metres, that's it. Just, is that including the runoff, or is that the actual weight? Let's go for 37 metres. We're not measuring, no, it's not four.
That was a confirmed, thank you very much.
Well done, 37 metres. This is it. Nice. 17 metres. I don't know where he's got 37 from. I don't know. Sort of a funny sized tape measure.
Go on, sir. Jerry's in. It's in fourth gear, sir.
Ready to go?
Yeah, I think you're in the gear now.
What do you want me to do? Make it look really difficult to start off with?
That is a lot harder than he makes it look. I've spent maybe half an hour trying and I'm shattered. How he did an hour and a half and 37 miles like that. Fair play to him. I don't think I'm up for Trials World Championship yet. I'm going to stick to really big road bikes with lots of power. It's a damn sight easier and you can sit down. Oh man. Right, well, I've ridden a bike and I think I've impressed Dougie, sort of. we were saying about the riding position thing. I haven't ridden a bike. I managed to get 1 foot on the rear pegs, but had to keep one on the normal conventional side pegs. And that's something you found when you were starting off. It's a different experience.
Yeah, it is really different at the back. I knew I needed to be there for the sort of distance we were going, but it just feels so alien. It's something that just takes a lot of time to get used to and a lot of using sort of the rear brake up on the handlebar, which is, you know, sort of normally for, for your front brake, you see. So that's just a whole new learning experience.
Yeah, because when you're on the tail ones, for me the bike felt longer, it was a long way away, and then when it came up it seemed quite a scary experience. It came up differently, it seemed like a sharper action.
It's a lot sharper action. It seems like a real pendulum, and the sort of sweet spot for where the front wheel height is sort of a very small area as well. So,
and when you're hitting that spot you have to be on the brake, because
if you're not going to hit the brake as soon as it's getting there, then obviously you just fall straight off the back.
And that's why
it's building up to that.
It is. I mean, the short burst I had, I couldn't have enough bravery to go to know where the front brake was. When I'm on a road bike, I know where the back brake is and what.
Yeah.
So you can play with it. I didn't feel like I was playing with the brake, so I couldn't. I don't know what it looked like from the side of the road. Probably quite pathetic. But but for me, it felt. I didn't feel have the confidence to push that little bit more to get a balance, and that's where you need to know where.
I mean, I imagine from where you were, the position you were on the bike, you thought you were fairly well up towards.
Oh man, I was pulling 180s all day long. It's 12 o'clock.
It needed a fair bit more, really, to sort of get to the back brake territory.
Yeah,
you weren't going to loop it it out anywhere.
Oh, was I not?
No.
But I was really surprised by the engine as well, because it's a two-stroke engine, so there's obviously no engine braking, but you're saying you've got quite a heavy flywheel on it.
Yeah, there's a quite a heavy flywheel weight on it, and an extra half kilogram on that one as well, and the mapping's adjusted to make it smoother as well, because obviously you're just working on sort of the first 20-30% of the throttle, that's all.
Yeah, because it was surprisingly... Yeah, when you could play with it, when it was up, you could... you had enough control to do that.
I just tried to make it sort of as easy as possible there, so that I did have some recovery there, but also not too lazy that if I was in a bit of trouble where I had to sort of really yank it to sort of get out of it.
I mean, the one time I sort of floated slightly, I said sort of shut throttle. You do... The problem with two-stroke is you get that half second of nothing. And you do get a little float every now and then. That was a bit worrying.
Yeah, that's also with the weight that we've got on the crankshaft and the weight and everything of the flywheel that sort of gives it a bit of delay, doesn't it, when you shut the throttle?
Yeah, that's the polite way. I think
panic time.
Well, I think if there'd been a seat, there'd been a pinch mark in it. but and also, you say, I noticed as well, like we were talking about this briefly earlier, when I was getting tired, I mean, I'm not massively fit, but I was only going up and down and bouncing it with my legs to bring it up and then holding it. But the more tired I get, the more it was wobbling, and that was definitely noticeable, that you need to be fit and concentrating and knowing what's going on, otherwise it's very easy to get
your arms do tire on it, that is for sure, especially you know trying to go up and down quite a few times, and when your arms are tired, you know, to get that such equal, you know, pull from the bounce and dropping the clutch to pulling it up, if it starts veering straight away, you never get it back, so it's so critical, is that first part.
Yeah, it is, but the nice thing is it's a slight slower speed. I think I was touching a dizzy 15 miles an hour there. And so honestly, I mean, you hop on like an MT10, you can put that down at 130 miles an hour. And that's the crazy thing. Like, you know, it's like the MT10, you're into fifth gear at 130, 140 miles an hour at about wheel. That feels quite safe. But that thing felt terrifying.
Did it not feel that? At almost running pace, it didn't feel that safe.
I don't think I could run that fast. You can see,
it looked like you were in control anyway.
I felt confident on him. I don't think I'm quite up to your standards yet. But there again, how long have you been riding trolls bikes?
Oh, since I was three, so we're on 37 years now, so it's been a while.
You're the same age as me.
Am I really?
Yeah, I'm 40 this year.
You get yourself booked in, TT course, we'll get a road closure. Get a few people together and see.
Yeah. So you're the same age as me, you've got 12 world titles, and you've lapped the 37 mile of TT on the back wheel. That makes you feel good about yourself, doesn't it?
Can't say that.